We are not your brother.
You seek land, true enough. Land that is not yours nor any person.
I only wish to protect. There are those who will betray and manipulate you. The worst yet, take the land by force.
We are all too aware of the expeditions your people send against us.
What do you mean, Mike? We are all one. We should act this stuff.
How? By signing our lands over to you? Then we'll be as one in your debt forever?
Sir William may have a point. What hope have we against their black powder and iron?
The spirits will guide us, as they always have.
Did they not guide us here?
Yes, that we might unmask the great betrayer.
This is a mistake. We should sign.
Peace! Peace! Have I not always been an advocate? Have I not always sought to protect you from harm?
If you wish to protect us, then give us arms, muskets and horses that we might defend ourselves.
War is not the answer.
We remember, Stanwix. We remember you moved the borders. Even today your men dig up the land, showing no regard for those who live upon it. Your words are honeyed, but false. We are not here to negotiate, nor to sell. We are here to tell you and yours to leave these lands.
So be it. I offered you an olive branch, and you knocked it from my hand. Perhaps you'll respond better to the sword.
Are you threatening us?
Yes. Oh, no. What have you done?
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye. That we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet, but they will. 'Tis the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye, because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
Ayawas neyate hagum sare, am dahyayum neskanas izagum haja.
Thank you. William Johnson is dead, and with him, the Templar plot to steal the land of my people. But in ending this threat, I have revealed another. On his body was a letter addressed to John Pitcairn containing orders to root out and destroy Patriot weapons and supplies. Should he succeed in this, the colonists will be unable to maintain their resistance, and the Templars will surely take control. So long as Pitcairn lives, the danger remains. I need to find him. He needs to die.